Welcome back to our discussion with Kampala Water General Manager here, Engineer Muhammad Lutaya, who is telling us about the water issues in Kampala. You were explaining to us why we still have water rationing here in Kampala.
Yes, I was mentioning, right now, as Kampala, we're able to produce around 400 million liters per day. So ideally, that should be enough to meet the demand. And like right now, we can see that the eastern part of Kampala is 24 hours, 7 days a week. The central part of Kampala is 24 hours, 7 days a week. Most parts of Kampala, would say almost 95% of our service area is 24 hours, 7 days a week. Now the areas where we still have challenges are the places at far ends of Kampala, especially the western part of Kampala. Those are the areas of maybe side of Matuga. You have places around Nansana, a few areas. Then you have Wakiso, Kachiri, Budo. And the problem or the reason is that despite the fact the first phase of the project focused on increasing the capacity to produce water, which has been achieved. But the project had a second phase of how do you carry this water from the treatment plant to all those places, and that's the project that is coming up. As part of the project is focusing on how do you evacuate water from some of it. We have a big reservoir in Sonde. So how do you take water from Sonde and carry it all the way to what? To Wakiso. So we plan as part of that project to put a big tank in Kanyanya, on Kanyanya Hill. So from Kanyanya Hill, most of the water will be able to gravitate all the way to Wakiso. So that's something that we're working on. We are aware. And we apologize to those customers that are affected. I think the most important thing right now, what we do is that to make sure that even the water that goes there is distributed more or less to everyone. That's why we have the rationing program to achieve that. But also there are so many other interventions. You find that even Kajansi, that side of Chitende, yeah. Kampala is growing, Sisa, there's a lot of development taking place, and those places are also water challenged. So we're doing another very big project, which is starting this year, to lay a big pipe from Gaba. Because right now, like I said, we have enough capacity. Katosi is at almost 40% capacity utilization. So it means that we have even another 60% to utilize. When we added Katosi on board, Gaba also now we generated more capacity there. So what we're trying to do is lay a big pipe from Gaba across the bypass and serve the customers and the people in Kajansi, in Chitende, and those areas that are right now not having enough water. And I believe by end of this year or next year, we should have also those places fully covered. So the case of rationing is not because we don't have enough water. But for the places where we still have rationing, it's because the capacity of the infrastructure that we have is not adequate to carry the water from some of the reservoirs to those places. And it's not that we didn't know about it, but it was intentional, because it was not making sense. You first lay the infrastructure when you don't have water. So the plan was first guarantee that you have capacity to produce, and then you enhance the capacity transmission line. So that's what we're working on now.
Okay, Kampala has 3.86 million people. How many people are on that transmission grid now?
Like I said, for us, actually, our service area is beyond Kampala. You understand?
Yeah, Kampala metropolitan.
Yeah, it's ours. When you look at our boundaries as national, what we call Kampala, is bigger than the definition of Kampala by, you know. So it means that for us, and that's what we've always done, We're not defined by boundaries of Kampala, but we're defined by what? The demand, for our services and our capacity to meet that demand. So we've gone beyond the boundaries of Kampala with the intention, making sure that as long as we can serve you, we should be able to what? Serve you, whether you're within the boundaries of Kampala or out of these boundaries. So you realize the people we're talking about, most of them are not in the boundaries of what? We're in Wakiso, we're in Wakachiri. When you talk about Kampala metropolitan, might not have some of those areas. But for us, they are part of our service area, and we're doing everything possible to make sure that they are served.
Okay. Then there are those areas like Lugazi that are not even close to some of those areas you're talking about, but are completely off the Kampala grid or in terms of the location and how they should be served. It is said that you also serve some of those areas, like you just said. How do you do that?
You see, when they were designing the Katosi project, they defined the service area for Katosi project. And this service area was largely defined by where we had water supply challenges. When you look at an example of Lugazi right now, most of the water from Lugazi comes from boreholes. And again, Lugazi are so significantly expanded. So there's a lot of development, there's a lot of activity, and there's a lot of demand for water. Right now, the system we have there is not able to meet that demand. So one of the, again, part of the second part of the project for Katosi was to carry water from Sumba. We have the big reservoirs there, for those who have had the chance to look at them. And we're supposed to take that water all the way to what? To Lugazi, parts of Buikwe are supposed to be served by Katosi again. So already, that's now the steps we are undertaking. But on top of that, there's an immediate project we started to carry water back to Katosi. So we are, and this project should be completed by end of this month. So we are serving people in Katosi, the landing site, Kisoga, all those people we are connected our system from Sumba and taking water back to those places. And you see, like I told you, what the corporation is trying to do is whichever Ugandan is out there, irrespective of, you know, as long as we have the capacity to serve you. That's our objective.
So how many are those people? How many are you serving?
So in Kampala right now, for us, being when we look at our estimate, like I told you, we have almost 400,000 customers. Our service area in Kampala is talking about around 5 million people we're able to serve. When you look at the different routes, when you take Masaka Road, right now our service area is far as Maya and beyond. And we are still moving. So we have a project that will come in. We're calling it the Wakiso West. We're putting a big project in around that side of Kazi. And the objective is supposed to connect water all the way to Mpiji. And that will all be part of our service area. When you take Hoima Road, we go as far as Kachiri and Wakiso. And that is way beyond the Dimsewe boundaries for Kampala. Then when you take Mitiana Road, we are beyond, almost getting to Busuju. That's how far Kampala is for us. When you take Bombo Road, we are beyond Matuga. When you take Gayaza Road, we are beyond Chijabijo. We're almost getting to Karaji. That's as far. Because you see, there's a lot of dwelling in that area. And like I said, for us, we're not defined by the district boundaries, but we're defined by demand and our capacity to serve those people. Mukono Road, we go as far as beyond Barara, to Namaujoro. That is all Kampala. Now, like I told you, our plant in Katosi is 555 kilometers from Kampala. So you find that the radius for Kampala is almost like 30, 35, coming almost 40 kilometers. And when you talk about myself, just in Kampala alone, is over 5 million. So, and we believe, as long as, like I told you right now, we have capacity. Now, the second phase of the project is see how we can evacuate more water, build bigger transmission mains, and then be able to serve more people even beyond those boundaries, the boundaries we have right now.
Yes.
So physical boundaries we have. So we're not defined by boundaries, we're defined by demand and our capacity to serve the people.
Yes. There are some areas in Kampala, for example, in areas of Kansanga, Gaba, Chisugu, Muyenga, that have an old infrastructure system and the pipes are old, they have leakages. And from time to time, they do burst, so the water flows in the roads and into people's homes. What plans do you have for such areas?
So we have, that's one of our biggest challenges. When you look at, like I said, we're losing like 40%. All that 40%, there's what, and we're trying to define what we call economic level of our losses. There are losses that the cost of reducing them is more than the saving you can make. So the cost of replacing the old infrastructure in some of those places is not a small cost. Because you can imagine the level of development you have in that side of Kansanga. And if you try to replace all those pipes, it's not going to be a very cheap project. But right now what we're doing as a corporation, make sure that for the leakages that are found, we respond to them as fast as possible. The old lines, we systematically replace them. Yeah, and we have a project that is coming that is going to focus on the largely the CBD or the old Kampala, where we have frequent bursts, to see how we can have most of those pipes, first of all, replaced, but some of them even upgraded. But the other thing that also you realize and notice, for especially that side of Kansanga, is this is a place where we have high pressure. So when you have high pressure, the pressure is quite high. Though other places are complaining of low pressure, the challenge of Kansanga is the level of what the pressure is high. So what we're trying to do is, again, as there's a project we're doing to manage the pressure. So there's technology you can use that can help you reduce the pressure. And once we reduce the pressure, then you can also manage the what? The leakages as well. So places where we have high pressure, we're trying to see how we can, with technology, be able to manage the pressure, and as part of the means to manage the leakages as well. So we don't just after repairing leakages, but right now we are moving to the stage of what? Of managing them, so that whatever you repair, you're sure it can't what? Then you also have quite a number of pipes that are exposed, yeah?
Yes.
You find them on the surface.
Yeah,
and some of them have happened because before the pipe was deepened enough, but when they're grading the road, all of a sudden it's exposed, yeah? So again, we want to work on a project to have most of those pipes deepened, so that again we minimize the recurrence of what? Of leakages. The other area we're dealing with, and this we're strengthening our partnership with KCCA and UNRA when they are doing roads, so that where we have pipes that we believe need to be relocated early or replaced, we're doing it as they're working on the roads, yeah? And also want to minimize the damage that is caused. You find sometimes when they're working on roads, you find some of our pipes are what? Are graded, we lose a lot of water, customers end up not getting water. So we have now a better working relationship with KCCA and UNRA, so that where they're doing some works, we are part of the team and we minimize the impact of cutting the pipes, but also where cases we have to relocate the pipe and deepen them, we're able to do that.
Yes, you talked about the pressure in those areas.
Yeah.
Also, sometimes the tanks are overflowing, and so you've got to pay for more water in some of those areas. How could someone manage with all that pressure? Because you said it's good, because that pressure is coming from the fact that the GABA plant is nearer to those areas and it's got to pump
some
water
of them are also
to
near
ends.
To our big reservoirs.
Yes.
That's Miyenga Reservoir. What we've tried to do with most of the customers who have challenges, if you have a challenge that your tank is overflowing, you have a challenge of high pressure.
Yes.
So we've worked with them, a number of them, and one, try to use again some bit of equipment that can help you reduce the pressure as it comes to your home. So there are pressure reducing valves that we put, which can help reduce the what? The pressure is arrested, you know? But also most importantly, again, the equipment you use, the pipes you have in your home, and that's what I talked about here. Some people have high bills, not because the bills are high, but just because the pipes you used. You know, sometimes when you're building, always go for the cheap pipes, yeah?
Yes.
So at the end of the day, you have poor quality pipes. Then you start getting water and they're leaking. And that is a huge cost. You try it. If you have just a tap which is just dropping, you put a bucket. By morning, that bucket is what? It's full. So you can imagine if that leakage is within your home or within the walls, to be doing it every day. And that also contributes to the what? To the bill. One, if the tank is overflowing, make sure you have a very high quality ball valve.
Mm-hmm.
You know, the ball valves have also different specifications and standards. They are the cheap ones that can withstand low pressure, but so you have those very good ones, irrespective of the pressure, you at least you have the assurance that your tank is not going to overflow. But I think what we request, like I said, National, our objective is not for a customer to have a high bill. It is never our objective. Our objective is to make sure the customer is comfortable with the bill. And if you have any challenge with your bill, kindly approach our offices. We work with you to help you deal with that problem.
Okay, now we go to the sewer lines, the sewage in the city, because you are National Water and Sewerage Corporation. How many people do you serve on that sewerage system?
In Kampala alone, I think we have around 30,000 customers connected.
Mm-hmm.
We believe within the city our coverage is over 20%. We've done a lot of investment in sewerage. We have 3 big treatment facilities, wastewater treatment facilities. We have the one of Rubiji. I think you see it on the northern bypass, that roundabout of Bwaise. As you go to Nansana roundabout, you see a big plant there. That's our Rubiji wastewater treatment plant. It helps us treat, collect and treat the waste from that side of Kampala. On top of treating the waste, also we generate fertilizers. So if you want fertilizers for your gardens, whatever it is, you can get them from that place.
On top of that, Lubiji?
In Lubiji, yeah. Yes. On top of that, actually, we worked with Water for People, and we are also making briquettes, which are substitutes for charcoal. Then we have another big plant in Nachivuo here, the Nachivuo wastewater treatment plant. And I think as you're going to Wankoko, as you're going to Bugolowi, you'll be able to see it. 5 years ago,
you know,
that place used to smell.
It still has a stench.
No.
It used to.
We're looking at it, and most people can testify. But the technology we've used right now, that smell has been dealt with. Yeah, the quality of the waste we get, that water is as clean as most of the water you see in bottles.
So you're saying that the smell around Wankoko is not as
has
bad.
Been dealt with. Yeah,
it's not as bad as what it used to be.
No, it's been dealt with. Has been dealt with. On top of that, at that plant, we're able to generate electricity every month. So part of the electricity we use to run that plant is coming from the waste. So that's how unique. That's one of the biggest plants we have in the region. And as national, as Uganda, we are proud of that. Then we have another one, Ichinawataka, again, which we use it. Now, the one of Nachivubo, I mean, the one of Golobi, we use it to treat the biggest part of the what? Of the city. Then you have another in Ichinawataka. Then there's another one that is being built in Nalukolongo as well. So it shows you the focus of the corporation to make sure that we don't just provide water, but also we deal with sewerage. So there are intended projects that we're trying to put in place to increase now the network for sewage. Because one thing, like I told you, with water, we have the capacity to produce. Right now we have the capacity to treat the sewage. The next part is we need to increase our capacity to collect this sewage from wherever it is. So make sure that most parts of Kampala are also sewered and connect to our sewer. Okay. But you still have a challenge. Even places, even customers who are close to our sewer lines, you find that they are not connected. Some of them prefer keeping their septic tanks, and when it rains, they open the septic tank to the public.
Yes, exactly where I was going. Yeah. Why do we have overflowing septic tanks whenever it rains here in Kampala?
It's an illegality. I won't say that again, mafias, but it's an illegality that we're trying to deal with. The most important thing, we're working closely with cases here to at least to make sure that if you have a building in the city close to a sewer line, you're required by law to make sure that it's connected to the what? To the sewer line, to minimize those health hazards. Because at the end of the day, I think it's all our interest to have a clean city. That's our objective, and that's what Nashota is trying to do. That we provide the infrastructure. Government is putting in place the infrastructure to make sure that we have a very clean what? City. Now, as citizens, as Ugandans, I think it's also our responsibility. If the infrastructure is there, you need to connect to it. Especially if you have a building that houses a certain number of what? People, it's required of you to have it connected.
The good thing is that what does it take to be connected on it?
It's as easy as getting water connection. So right now, like I told you, we put our systems online. To get a water connection, whether it's Sunday, whether 8 a.m., whether in Uganda, whether in Moroto, you can apply for what? For water, and in time. So we've made, and that's the convenience we've tried to create for our customers, that if you want water previously, if you wanted sewer connection, you had to walk to our offices. Right now, if you want water, if you want a sewer connection, please go online and apply. If you can't access online services, then you can visit any of our offices. We receive your application, we process it. We always guarantee after you paid within 2 weeks maximum, you should be connected to water or should be connected to sewer.
Okay, you talked about having about 20% on your sewer line. Are you doing a good job?
like I said, the way we assess ourselves whether we're doing a job is basically from the feedback we get from our customers. But we know we need to do better with what? Sewage services. That's why you see the investment that is being put to first increase the capacity to treat, but then next part also increase the capacity to collect. Yeah. So we believe we can do much better. I think the target for sewage coverage for Kampala is supposed to be around 30%. We also know that it's not possible, that these are people who are directly connected to our what? Sewer line. But remember, even if you have a septic tank in Muyenga, we still treat it. You understand? So it means that we collect this using what? Cesspooling emptiers to our treatment plant. So in principle, our coverage for sewerage is not just 30%, but say, technically, it could be even 90%. Because most of the waste that is generated in the city, we have the capacity to what? To treat it. The 30% we talk about is that those that are directly connected to our sewer lines. But whoever has a septic tank, wherever you are, is still that waste is collected and treated in our what? From city. So in principle, we are covered, and we know that economically or technically, it's not going to be possible that we have 100% everyone connected to a sewer line. But we know that those customers, a number of them, we're going to serve them using the septic tanks.
Okay, so can you tell us about the new billing systems for National Water, the e-billing systems? Is it extended to that part of the service as well?
Yeah, recently, I think starting August last year, we brought on board a new, I would say even innovation, a new option for our customers. When we went through the COVID period, there were so many lessons we learned. And you to take a stupid person not learn lessons. COVID presented so many challenges, but also presented us with lessons. In the beginning, there was some bit of confusion because of the nature in the way the message was structured. Because it would capture the units. A unit is 1,000 liters, what we call a unit. That's why all our messages have units. You've used one unit, it means that you've used 1,000 what? Liters. If you use two units, those are 2,000 what? Liters. The message would only capture the units used and the amount of water outstanding, including the areas. So people would see the units and then say big figure down. They say like, how could I have used all this amount of money? That's when there was a confusion that, hey, National Water has increased what? The inflating bills. But just because the message, the figure of the money captured even the what? Areas you had.
Yes.
So we realized that was causing a lot of confusion. And we changed, restructured the message. Right now, when you get a message, it shows you how many units you've what? You've used, and how much money you've used that particular month. So, but again, the message comes with a link. Now, if you have a phone that is connected to the internet, when you click that link, you're able to view the full bill the way you'd get it physically.
Okay, more like a statement.
Yes, statement, you have it. Now, so it means that whichever type of phone you have, whether the phone they call Mapesa, whether Birauli, whatever it is, you still get what? A bill. But the most important thing is you get your bill instantly. Also, you keep a record in your phone that last month it is this. This month, you're able to monitor and review. Now, we've gone a step further. In the beginning, there was a challenge. Most people are not getting their bills because we didn't have the right what? Contacts in the system. So we've used this period from August to clean up. We've been calling our customers. We've been, when our people come to visit, they've been collecting the right what? Customer contacts, yeah? In the field. But also we've allowed customers, if you're not getting your bills, please approach any of our offices so that your accounts and your phone numbers are updated. And right now, I would say we're almost 98% in Kampala. All customer contacts have been what? Updated. We've taken it further to appreciate that in Kampala, not everyone is a landlord. There are people who are tenants.
Yes.
So previously, the fact that the bill was delivered physically, you would get it. They would deliver it to the apartments. Right now, in the system, we only had the number for the what? For the landlord. So all these messages, we are going to the what? To the landlord. So, but we improved on that. We're saying even if you're a tenant,
you should register, be able to get your
you
bill.
You can register as a tenant by yourself and be getting bills on your phone as a what? tenure, to the extent that if you shift, today being staying in Matuga, and say to go to Mukono, you yourself, without even going to any of our offices, you go to the our website, you capture, you put in your details, and you change. You deactivate Matuga, you activate what? Mukono.
Okay.
That's how we're trying to make it as convenient as possible for our customers.
That's very convenient, but our time is fast paced. We have had an interesting 1 hour, but before we go, I want to know, or the viewer there may want to know, what plans do you have for people who are not yet able to have piped water?
When you look at the agenda of the corporation,
yes,
and you look at all our documents, right now we're emphasizing water for all. That is our what? Mantra. We believe we have an obligation as a corporation to make sure that every Ugandan where we provide services, like right now we're in 264 towns, it's our responsibility to make sure that every Ugandan has what? Has water. The discussion we've had, I told you our boundaries are not defined by administrative what? Boundaries are defined by the need,
yes,
and also our capacity to provide.
Mm-hmm.
So as a corporation, there are so many projects we're undertaking. Just like we had Katos here, there are so many projects that are taking place across the country. Yeah, be it in Moroto, be it in Kaptura, be it in Hoima, be it in Barara, be it in Singro. If I start listing the projects we're undertaking, we also have almost another hour. But the most important thing is that the corporation is doing everything possible. We put in place plans in the next 3-5 years to make sure that the places where we operate, like I said, we extend water to the citizens, to the Ugandans, and make sure that at least every Ugandan what is served with piped water.
Thank you very much, Engineer Mahmoud Lutaya. We do want to thank you for joining us for this checkpoint this week. And we are always here bringing you the different entities and checking on the different organizations and what they are doing for our people here. We also bring those that have had some questions from the public. You did hear him about the inflated bills, and we hope that your answers have been gotten from this interview. And please do join us next week on Tuesday, 10 p.m., The Checkpoint.